Gentlemen, welcome to Comedy Fight Club. Please welcome your commissioner, Matt Merritt!
Tonight, egos will be wounded, feelings will be hurt, because we don't come here to make friends, we come here to fight! This is humiliation. This is brutality. Anything goes. No holds barred. This is Comedy Fight Club. Thank you all for coming. Now, welcome to Comedy Fight Club, streaming on the Gas Digital Network every Wednesday night at 10:30 and coming to you live from the CFC Arena. I'm the official commissioner of Comedy Fight Club, the sleeveless wonder of the world, Matt Maron. And the reason we are on Twitter and Instagram at County Fight NYC is because our social media hipster. Give it up for Nico Pav. Got a great show in store for you tonight. Every week, the best comedians in New York City, and tonight, Philadelphia. Last week, Philadelphia. Comedians from all over are coming to Fight Club now. They're going to get on stage and say the most mean, vicious, brutal, offensive shit to each other. And if you want to get offended and write a blog about it, go to another show. This isn't for you. How does that sound? No, Fight Club, if you want to get offended, go the fuck somewhere else. This is where real shit gets said. Are you guys ready for this show? Oh, yeah. All right, so we're going to have four undercard battles, one main event coming up for you guys, and the winners of these fights will be determined by our esteemed judges panel over here. Yeah. We're going to meet them now up first, not sitting at the table over there, but sitting in front of me right now. Each and every single one of you from this point forward is a part of Fight Club because you will applaud for who you think wins each fight. All of your applause will count for one vote in each of these fights. That means you have to have all the energy in the fucking world. Fight Club, let me hear. Are you feeling good tonight? Yeah. You get to pick the winners of all these fights. Are you ready for that responsibility? All right, now we're going to meet our judges over here. First up, from Comedy Central's Roast Battle, give it up for Olivia Grace. What's up, Olivia? How are you doing?
I didn't know I was supposed to say something. I'm good. How are you?
Good. Do you have any advice for the roasters coming up to the stage tonight?
Try being funny. That's usually like the first thing.
Fight Club, give it up for Olivia Grace. And up next, also from Comedy Central's Roast Battle and host of the Broad Topics podcast on Gas Digital Network, give it up for Kim Congdon.
Thank you.
What's up, Kim? How are you feeling tonight?
I'm good. I have literally never seen a host spit more. Are you guys okay up there? It's like fucking SeaWorld. Yeah, this is fun. I'm excited to be here. Sorry for calling you out, but you're
that's okay.
What you're doing to them almost looks like a hate crime because they're brown.
You have any advice for the fighters coming up to the stage tonight?
Well, yeah. Me and Olivia Grace, actually, we roasted each other. We got on TV doing this, and we're just here, so it doesn't take you far.
Fight Club, give it up for Kim Congdon. And up next, one host of the citywide show right here every Thursday night at the Sand Comedy Club and almost a cast member of Saturday Night Live. Get up for Shane Gillis!
Yes. Almost. Almost had it.
What's up, Shane?
I've been better. yeah. No, this will be fun. This is always fun. I love doing this. I don't know why you say brutals. You gotta cut out brutal out of the
brutal.
That's a tough word for you.
That's fair.
And I don't know why you lean on it. So like that, if you get triggered, you better write a blog about it. Stop with that. That's corny. But that's my advice to the fighters. Don't, if you have a speech impediment, don't say fucking brutal.
Don't be the host.
Yeah, don't host. Don't use a mic.
Fight Club, give it up for Shane Gillis. And you know what? Fuck it. If he wants people to write more blogs about him, do it. I don't care. And up next, also from Philadelphia, host of the You Fucked It podcast, give it up for Brian Six.
Hey. Thanks, buddy.
What's up, Brian? How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing great, man.
First time judging one of these. Are you excited?
I am. I am. You have two Philly people going up against each other tonight.
Yeah,
so
later on we got two Philly
that.
Comics.
Yeah. Well, they're all gay, so it doesn't matter.
That's fair. You have any advice for any of the roasters coming up to the stage
tonight?
Be
better than the opening acts. Yeah. And I co-host a podcast with the one. What's up, Shainer? What's up?
All right, give it up for Brian Six, I guess. And our final judge tonight from MTV's Wild N' Out and America's Got Talent, give it up for Jacob Williams.
Hello, how's it going?
What's up, Jacob? How are you feeling tonight? Excited, I assume?
I feel very excited. You can tell from my voice, probably. I'm ecstatic to be here. Advice to have high energy the whole show, much like I do.
Fight Club, give it up for Jacob Williams. And now with us here every week are the officials of Comedy Fight Club, keeping us hyped all night. Give it up for our spirit animal, Justin Lanza.
Yeah, Jacob, you and me use this.
And the official bishop of Comedy Fight Club, the king of the bits, the one, the lonely, Andrew Casertano. And finally, before we kick off this show, one of the most important parts of the show, Fight Club, give it up for DJ Charlottesville.
You will not replace us!
You will not replace us! You will not replace us! You will not replace us!
Billy, we're like, whoa, relax.
If that didn't recover the energy of this room, I don't know what will. Fight Club, are you ready to see some fights right now? No, I said, are you ready to see some fucking fights tonight? Let's get this started up. First, we have an undercard bout, five jokes, tip for tat. Introducing first, he looks like Manny Pacquiao if he were a graphic designer, Luke Trovis.
Up on Gangnam Style. Not this time, man. Not this time. You can't get me dancing mode.
What's up, Luke? How you doing?
I'm doing good, man. I'm doing good. How are you doing?
Good. You know your opponent very well?
Yeah, I met him once.
Okay. We're going to meet him right now. He is the host of the Crush Boys podcast. Crush Boys is also his favorite sex act, Dwayne Cullen! What's up, Dwayne? How are you feeling?
Good. Feeling good.
Good. You know Luke well? You met him once. You like Luke?
Yeah, he's so small. Yeah, if I lose, I'm going to have to beat him up.
Good start, guys. which one of you wants to go first? Luke's going to go first. Dwayne's going second. Fight Club, are you ready for your first fight tonight? Let's do this, starting now.
Dwayne looks like he date rapes to Mumford and Sons. Okay.
Luke lives at home with his mom. His mom still orders Yellow Pages, but not for the numbers, just so he can sit up at the dinner table.
Dwayne, you Euro trash American. Dwayne used to work at a Starbucks. He got fired in Ireland when. Fuck me. Fuck! You can do this, Luke. It's fine. Dwayne, you Eurotrash American. Dwayne got fired from a Starbucks in Ireland when a lady ordered a tall Americano and he showed her his dick. We got through it, guys.
Hell yeah. Luke's dad left his family. Oh, wait, no, sorry. First joke. Luke's dad is a New York police officer that used to beat his immigrant mom. You know, it must be nice to have a father who can work from home. All right.
Dwayne's parents are Irish. His mom is a drinker and his dad is gay. They had one thing in common. They both love Jameson. Okay.
Hell yeah. Luke's dad left his family, which really fits into the Asian stereotype of pretending to be black. All right. I thought that was a good joke. Was that...
Dwayne was part of a band called Orca Team. Orca, like the killer whale. A killer whale is also what you'll hear when Dwayne murders a child prostitute. Okay.
All right. You guys are amazing. isn't this crazy? Like, if you didn't know us and someone said, like, one of our dads is gay and the other is a cop, I think you would guess wrong.
Ha! Gay!
Last joke.
Dwayne.
First joke.
Dwayne's first job was a Dairy Queen. Dwayne's first job was a Dairy Queen, which is also what he called the fat girl he used to fuck in the break room.
Luke lives at home with his Asian mom and has a podcast where they review sneakers. I imagine it's just an hour of him going, man, I wish I could afford those.
Oh, yeah!
Okay, Fight Club, I guess it's time to pick a winner. Is the winner of this fight Luke Trovise? Or is the winner of this fight Dwayne Cullen? I think crowd vote by slightly more tepid applause goes to Luke Trovise. Go to our judges. Olivia Grace, what did you think of this fight?
Do you feel good about yourself, Luke?
No.
Okay. I love that you guys let looking at your phones ruin your stage presence and your jokes. That was pretty impressive.
Who do you think won?
I think we'll all win when this is over.
Okay. So one abstaining, one vote for Luke. Okay. Kim Congdon.
Wow, you guys, that was a very interesting battle. Dwayne, when you said the Yellow Pages joke, I thought that was going to go a whole different Asian direction. I love a good mislead, you know? And Luke, you really shocked me because I've never seen an Asian forget something. I thought you guys could memorize your jokes. I think that there was one round that got laughs, and it was Luke, and it was the first joke, and so I'm going to give it to Luke for that.
Two votes for Luke Trovise. Shane Gillis, try to be unbiased here.
Yes. I didn't appreciate those Asian jokes you made. I thought, you know, it's not now. It's 2019. 2018, I would have done it. 2019, I think it's time for us to grow up a little, you know.
You already didn't get the job.
Yeah, I'll get more, though. None of you will. I will. Luke, I think, you know, I just know Luke, so I'll vote for him. That was a draw. You guys didn't, you know, no one won. That was bad. It wasn't good, but I like Luke as a person.
Yeah.
So vote for Luke.
Another vote for Luke Trovise. Yeah. Brian says.
Yeah, both of you are horrendous. You both stink at this. Luke, even worse, you had to go to your phone. Yeah. Like most of the open mics that you're on. But what's your name?
Oh, Dwayne.
Ah, it's a horrible name. I'll go with Luke.
Another vote for Luke Trovise. Jacob Williams, it's wrapped up, but what is your final thoughts on this battle?
Oh, all right. Well, I think you are both great. That's the best roast battle all night. So, Dwayne, even though it doesn't matter. All right.
Winner of this fight, Luke Trovise. What do you say, Fight Club? It can't get any worse. You ready for more fights? Your next fight, introducing first, she writes feminist think pieces, so you know she's funny, Lauren Vino!
There's a price to pay. Time for you to get down on your knees.
Oh, Matt, you live in a hut made of your own sleeves. Like,
How are you feeling tonight?
I'm good, man.
Good. You know your opponent very well?
Mm-hmm. She's one of my good friends.
Okay. Let's meet her now. Give it up for Slumdog Mustache Hair, Amama Sardar!
Thank you.
How are you feeling, Amama?
I'm good.
Good. You ready for this fight?
Hell yeah.
All right. Which one of you guys wants to go first?
I don't give a fuck. I'll go.
Mama's gonna go first.
All right.
Lauren's going second. Five jokes here for that fight club. You ready for this fight? This right. fight starts now.
Lauren has the body of a yoga instructor in the face of a meth addict.
Right. Mama is secretly racist. She does whiteface anytime she makes a guy come.
Lauren says she loves wrestling, but that's what she tells herself when men beat her up.
Amama is a Muslim, but she's not a fundamentalist. She eats pork, she drinks, and has a big hairy clit.
Guys, Lauren called off her wedding to a comedian, making it the first time a comic was excited to be canceled.
Damn!
Amama has to cover her face, not because she's Muslim, but because she's ugly.
It's good. Lauren loves to post pictures of her in crop tops, and men love to crop her face out of them.
Amama's ass is so flat, dudes think it's a glory hole.
Lauren, you look like the girl from Frozen if she lived in a trailer park and her superpower was sucking dick.
Last joke.
Mama looks like she breastfed till high school, but on her dad's dick.
Okay, so we stayed about moderately the same, I guess, then. We'll go to our judges. We'll start with Jacob Williams. What did you think of this fight?
All right.
I want to get the energy up, so I went to you, Jacob.
I thought it was amazing. You guys are great. I wish I had a joke ready. No, I got nothing. All right. I liked the covering face thing, and I'm glad I'm not battling because I would be losing right now. But I'm gonna give it to.
You're still losing.
Yes, just slightly.
Vote for Amama?
Yeah.
One vote for Amama. Go over to Brian Sex.
Yeah. I think that's the first time a judge walked people. I thought both of you stunk, but I'll be honest with you. You went tit for tat. How long have you been friends?
Like a year, yeah.
1 year? And you have that much against each other. I'll give it to the orange.
The orange? As long as you didn't say colored, so.
I meant the one in the white. No.
Yeah. Shane Gillis.
I thought Amama won.
Okay. Two votes for Amama. One for Lauren Vino. Book Shane Gillis and all your diversity shows. Fight Club, we'll go to you guys now. Do you think the winner of this fight is Lauren Vino? Or is the winner of this fight Amama Sardar? Crowd vote goes to Amama, so it's 3-1 right now. Kim Condon, what do you say?
This is why they say we're not funny. No, I'm just kidding. Honestly, you guys did way better than the first battle. You memorized your jokes. They you can tell that they were written and you worked on them and you practiced them, so thank you for that. But I did have, when I was keeping track, I had one for Amama and two for Lauren. Lauren for my vote.
So it's 3 votes for Amama, 2 votes for Lauren. Olivia Grace, what do you say?
My favorite joke was the glory hole joke. That was great. That was really great. The audience let you down on that one. Sorry. Well, no, not sorry, audience. Wow, Olivia, what are you doing? Your name is Amama? Okay, because you introduced me to yourself earlier, and you were like, I thought you said mama, and I was going to be like, mama, that's what I call myself when I'm hungry. Like, you know, like, mama's hungry, but that's not your name, so I don't know why I said that. But I like, the glory hole joke was my favorite. So,
So it's tied. Three votes for Lauren, three votes for Amon. We'll go to you guys one more time. Sorry, Lauren, you may have to hear this again. Clap for who you think wins this fight. Crowd vote's going to be the tiebreaker. Do you think the winner of this fight is Lauren Vino? Olivia turned them on the glory hole joke, I think. Or is the winner of this fight Amama Sardar? Okay, barely. Winner of this fight, Amama Sardar!
Wait. You mean to tell us we have so much influence that we could do the clap before, then we vote, and then they can change their claps?
I could have done one.
Didn't they clap for the same battle twice?
I could have done one.
You guys are fucking traitors. You don't believe in what you're thinking.
I could have done one more joke, but nobody wanted that.
It's because I bullied them. I have power.
What do you say, Fight Club? Are you ready for another fight? No, more energy than that. Come on, we got three more fights. Two undercard, one main event. Are you ready for the rest of the show? All right, up next, introducing first, he got kicked off Epstein's Island for being too creepy, Dave Sheehan! We can dance if we want to. We can leave. What's up, Dave? How are you doing?
I'm awake.
Good. Okay. We're going to meet your opponent now. He's got the charisma of a ceramic frog, John Moskowitz! I want a brand new house. I want a foreign little bitch. She put it all in her. What's up, John? How are you feeling?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. You ready for this fight?
Sure.
Okay. Which one of you guys wants to go first?
All right. I'll go first.
John's going to go first. Dave's going second. Fight Club, are you ready for this fight? I said it couldn't get any worse before. I really believe it this time. Are you ready for this fight? Five jokes, tit for tat. This fight starts now.
All right. Dave's asexual. He looks like Mr. Peanut and never busted one.
First blood.
John looks like Rachel Maddow went in for an appendectomy, but they mistakenly gave her transgender surgery.
All right, Mr. Dirty. Dave mentors children and does martial arts because he couldn't hold them down without technique.
Wow, wow, he's very nice.
John is a Jewish post-millennial, which means his go-to karaoke song is "It's Getting Hot in Here."
Get over here!
Dave came here from Connecticut tonight, but it's not a big deal for him. He's gone a lot further to meet a lot younger boys.
John has never been right in the head, dating back to the night his parents conceived him. They couldn't find their Barry White CD, so they threw on an Insane Clown Posse CD instead.
Do Jews listen to the Insane Clown Posse? I'm confused. Okay. Dave started comedy in the year 2002. Quit.
Shots fired! Shots fired!
John looks like he spent all four of his high school years as president of the Jason Mraz fan club, and that his yearbook named him most likely to die from an overdose of Axe body spray.
Last joke.
Dave's like Professor X if the semen of his students gave him his walking ability back.
John looks like his college major was Mario Kart. There's probably a section on his Tinder profile that says, if you don't at least make an effort to get along with all 17 of my sock puppets, F-O-H.
Anyone think that guy was going to drop an F-O-H on the show? All right, we'll go to our judges over here. Shane Gillis, we'll start with you. What do you think of this fight?
I thought John won the first... That, yeah, John won. I think you guys, everybody's being really hard on themselves. You know? I know it's like a roast thing, but so far everybody's been like, everybody here sucks, this sucks. Yeah, who cares? It sucks. Have fun.
Yeah.
You got, yeah, that's all right. John won.
One vote for John Moskowitz.
Oh, you guys have a little fun. And enough with the cameras. There's too many cameras for this. There's more cameras than people here, and it's very, very uncomfortable.
Yeah, the ratio of technology to enthusiasm is drastically out of whack.
Speaking of enthusiasm, Jacob Williams, what do you think of this fight?
All right. Yeah, I think John won. I think Dave is kind of like Professor X because his jokes didn't have legs. But this night has really put the sad in stand, and that's all I got. You know?
Two votes for John Moskowitz. Brian Six, yeah, what do you think?
I thought both guys were great. That was great. Give it up for these guys, man. Those two were great. But I'll give it to you, Green. You were good. I'm sorry, I forget your name. Something ends with a wits. But there you go.
Three votes for John Moskowitz. Olivia Grace.
Hi, Dave. Are you okay?
Jury's still out.
Okay. You look like you cry.
Like you?
Well, then maybe I'm right about this, because you look like you've been crying all day, and then as soon as you leave, you'll be crying once again. That's sort of... Your eyes look like Jacob Williams' voice. I honestly want to give it to Dave, because you worked your phone into your stage presence. Like, I like that you made it seem like, I read off my phone. That is who I am, you know? That's where my jokes are, and that's how I'm going to do it. You committed to the phone reading, which is, I brought it up several times, and it's clearly a pet peeve of mine. So thank you for making it seem a little bit less like, you know, I'll give it to you. That's what I say about that. That's the end of my sentence.
Three votes for John Moskowitz, one vote for Dave Sheehan. Kim Condon, what do you say?
This was the best out of the three, and that's not saying much. Dave?
Yes,
Dave. Dave, you look like you have like girls in your basement that have seen all 42 of your personalities. Your jokes were good, but I think that John, if you were in a band, it'd be called No Direction. But I think you edged it over tonight.
So John's got it wrapped up. Fight Club winner of this fight, John Moskowitz. And up next, we got two fights left. Up next, two battlers from Philadelphia. Came up to New York City to battle for you guys tonight. Are you guys ready for this fight? All right, up first, he's a talented artist. The only thing he can't draw is a crowd. Justin Kupo! How you doing, Justin?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Are you ready for this fight?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Let's do it.
Awesome. We're going to meet your opponent now. I would say she looks like dog shit, but people pick up dog shit. Rachel Rowan! Thank you.
I'm really liking this torture lighting.
Yes. You guys know each other very well?
No, but I do have sex with them occasionally.
Cool. I found them. So let's see how this battle goes. Which one of you guys wants to go first?
Yeah, fuck it.
Rachel's going to go first. Justin's going second. Fight Club, are you ready for this fight?
All right.
Five jokes, tit for tat. This fight starts now.
All right. Give it up for the brawny guy if he lost his fortune and became an alcoholic. You're up.
Oh, that was your joke. That was short. That was way quicker than I thought it would be. All right, give it up for Extra Large Marge. All right. Rachel, you got a real lunch lady next door vibe to you. You're like the principal from Matilda if she became a truck stop escort.
Damn! All right, give it up for Yawn Candy. Justin's smart, though. I like to call him the encyclopedia, you know, because he's huge, he's boring, and completely irrelevant.
Thank you, Roseanne Open Bar. Rachel's from a small town in Florida, and I'm not saying she's a redneck, but her family crest is a dented beer can that says, "Get her done."
Give me a hell yeah!
Thanks, Slim Jim Belushi. Believe it or not, Justin's actually from Clearwater, Florida, and he moved to Philadelphia, which is like moving from a dumpster to a dumpster fire.
Thank you, Doughy Deschanel.
Woo!
Fuck.
Rachel, Rachel is mostly known as a drunken mess. Her liver has seen more abuse than a stewardess on an Epstein flight.
Shit. Justin's favorite drink is chocolate milk and vodka because he says the kids can never taste the vodka.
Thank you, Carmel Electra.
Yeah.
Rachel is more desperate for attention than a half-assed suicide attempt. She told me that... She told me the only reason she wants to get famous is to make her family jealous, but I think it's just so she'll, that they know that she exists at all.
Bless you.
That was deep. give it up for the Pillsbury Doughboy's deadbeat father. actually, Justin once told me that his favorite way to drive is with a stick shift because it gives him complete control of the vehicle. Too bad they don't make stick shifts for appetites.
Thank you, Chrissy Manateigan. Rachel likes to show off her tits, which is cool. She's got great tits, you know? Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you.
It's, Yeah, she's got great it's the rest of her body that's the problem. Rachel's built like a meatball that was made by a guy with Parkinson's.
We gotta fucking fight. Give it up for both of these guys.
I just want to point out, he fucks this meatball, so.
We'll start with you guys, Fight Club. Do you think the winner of this fight is Rachel Rowan? Or is the winner of this fight Justin Kupo? Crowd vote goes to Justin Kupo. Go to our judges, Kim Condon. We'll start with you. What do you think of this fight?
That was a really fun battle, you guys, for real. You both did really great, very entertaining. It's Rachel and Justin, yeah. Justin, you killed it with the name puns. I loved Roseanne Open Bar, Doezy Chanel, whatever the fuck. Really great. But honestly, I got very distracted by the fact that you guys fuck, because then I was like, you pulled out some deep shit. You were like, this is her dream, is to show off to her family, dumb bitch. Like, you could tell that he pulled out, like, the pillow talk. And then I got distracted because I was like, you know, one of them likes the other more, and who is it? And, like, what is this dynamic? Someone's hurting here. But, Justin, you did better, and now there's just something to think about.
Two votes for Justin Kupo. Shane Gillis, what do you think of this fight?
I thought it was great. Both of you guys are really funny. Damn, it sucks. When did you guys move to Philly?
A year ago.
Oh, right when I got out. A year ago. Yeah, it seems like, yeah. We could have been pals.
Yeah.
I think the three of us would fucking do work. We go, there's some, get some cheesesteaks, crush some hoagies.
I love those cheesesteaks.
The three of us would crush hoagies.
A lot of things you did, a lot of things Shane did a year ago that he regrets.
Yeah. I thought you won. But yeah, you guys are both cool.
Another vote for Justin Kupo. Come down here. Olivia Grace, what did you think of this fight?
I thought that was really fun. You guys have almost no chemistry, though. The first time she was like, and we fuck. I was like, what did she say? And then the second time you said it, I was like, I guess they fuck. And I picture you guys, because he seems a little tired for that kind of thing, you know? How do you guys fuck? She just, like, yell at your dick and be like, go away! And then he comes, like, I don't know.
That's literally exactly what happened.
I knew it. See, I got a skill for that sort of thing. Next time, call me and tell me how it went. Anyways, I'm leaning towards you, because I did like your last joke. That last joke was really good. I forgot what it was, but I know I liked it.
It was when the whole crowd chanted tets.
All right, yeah, that's, you know what, yeah, that's, that might have been the one thing I liked about it the most. So I think that everybody got to come together and have a fun time because of that.
So it's another vote for Justin Kupo. He's got it wrapped up. We'll go down here. Brian Six, what do you think of this fight?
First question, are you guys going back to Philly tonight?
No.
Oh, I was looking for a ride. Honestly, I didn't listen to any of this battle. It was horrible. I'll give it to tits, though.
So it's 4 votes for Justin, 1 vote for Tits. Not sure who that vote goes to, honestly.
It's a toss-up.
Jacob Williams.
Yes, I think you both did well. I said that to everyone, but this time I'm being honest. You guys did well. Let's see. Justin's wearing bandages. He looks like he also kidnaps kids in them. All right, I'm glad I'm not battling. Justin wins.
Winner of this fight, Justin Kupo. And now we're going to hear from our spirit animal. It's party time. Get hyped. It's our spirit animal, Justin Lanza.
Yes. How you guys doing? Are you guys having fun? Oh, my goodness. It's so great to have you guys here. You guys look so beautiful tonight. Olivia and Matt Maron, you guys are giving me strong Arnold Schwarzenegger vibes, but the only thing you need to terminate is a pregnancy between cousins. All right, we're going to go through a couple of these battles, and I'm going to get off the stage here. Luke Trevisi and Dwayne Cohen, fuck you guys for turning on the crowd. These guys came all the way from Montreal to get two of America's main exports, shit-talking and school shooters. And you failed them both. I can't fucking believe it. I am sorry for the way this went down tonight. Justin Kupo and Rachel Rowan, there was less eye contact during this battle than I'm assuming you're having during your terrible, terrible sex. I do love the idea of her being Zooey Deschanel, though, like, oh, maybe one day I'll become a pizza. And that's all I got to say. I'm super eager to see the rest of the fights. Keeping on for Mr. Matt Maron.
The spirit animal, Justin Lanza. And now, Fight Club, it's time for our main event of the evening. It's the best of the best now. It's going to be a 3-round battle. We're going to go to our judges in between the rounds. We'll wait till the end to pick a winner. But now, Fight Club, 3-round battle, main event. Are you ready for the main event for this, Fight Club? All right, introducing first from Orange County, New York. He's like the Native American population. He's small, red, and no one gives a shit. Bobby Sheehan! What's up, Bobby? One of the best roasters in New York City. One of the favorites of Comedy Fight Club. How are you feeling going to this main event?
I'm feeling good. I want to let it known my opponent is Canadian and I'm American, so a vote for me is a vote for America.
USA! 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 I don't hear Shane Gillis! USA! USA! Where is he? Has he left the room? USA! I want to thank you for coming out.
I actually, this is the last time I'm doing this. And for real. And I have a spot in like 10 minutes, so I am going to leave.
Okay, that's cool.
Woo.
I'm not going to do this anymore. I'm not even at the level of you here.
I don't have a spot in 10 minutes, but I'm going to leave.
Yeah. We're going to meet his opponent now. He is from Canada. He looks like he sells heroin at skate parks. Ryan Long. What's up, Ryan? How you doing? First time here at Fight Club. How you doing?
Oh, yeah, this will be fun. There we go.
All right, which one of you guys wants to go first in round one? Bobby's going to go first in round one. Ryan's going second. Fight Club, you ready for your main event? Yeah. All right, this fight starts now.
Round one, fight!
All right, so as I said, Ryan is Canadian. He's also the whitest person I know. Ryan, you look like your only black friend is Justin Trudeau.
I thought you do 5 and then I do 5.
Oh, now it's one back and forth.
Guys, we're having some technical difficulties. Bobby triggers a lot of female comedians because he looks exactly like Louis C.K.'s dick. If girls for real didn't want to see it.
If I'm Louis C.K.'s dick, that means I get seen by industry more than you. Okay. You look like you're happy Epstein's dead because he never returned your phone calls.
Bobby escaped Kick a Ginger Day because nobody wanted to touch him. Yes, his hair is red, but his messages to comedy club bookers are unread. Not a real comedian, just does roasts. Guys.
Honestly, dude, that was too fucking far. Okay. Ryan's visa says he's an extraordinary alien, but he's also an extraordinary predator.
Bobby looks like he's the member of the Carnival Freak Show that walks four paces behind the other freaks saying, "Hey, wait up, guys."
Excellent.
Last joke.
All right. Ryan speaks with focal fry, has a nose ring, and wears tight clothes. So I don't know if you're here to tell jokes or just talk about how rewarding your summer abroad was.
Bobby, again, is not a real comedian, just mainly does roast. This is kind of his whole thing. His big show business dream is to be Matt's job. So what he does, actually, he just, when he's at his house, he puts on a leather vest and jerks off in the mirror yelling, "Orange is the new Matt."
Catch me outside. How about that?
A great fucking first round for your main event. Give it up for both of them one more time. Go to our judges. Kim Condon, what do you think of this fight so far?
Really good battle, you guys. You both did really great. Bobby, I've seen you battle a few times. You're always really funny. I did see you one time at a show get completely naked and then make out with Tim Dillon. And I saw your red pubes. And I remember one time when I first started comedy, I was 22 years old, and there was this thing called the naked roast that was happening, and I was like, should I do it? And someone pulled me aside, and they said no, because forever, anybody who sees you in the future will always remember what your pussy looks like. And I was like, that is sexist. And you know what? No, it's not.
All right, so I feel like in Kim's mind, Bobby's in the lead so far. Olivia Grace.
Wow, all right. Good shit, guys. Really brought the energy up. It's nice. Love your orthopedic shoes. I wrote a note to myself, be nicer to the battlers.
Well, you don't have to pick a winner until the end of three rounds.
Okay.
You can say who you think won that round, We vote at the end of three rounds.
I'm leaning towards Bobby. Good job, Bobby. I love that I've never seen you do comedy without a cold. good work on that. So I'm leaning towards Bobby. Thank you.
All right, Jacob Williams, what do you think of this fight after round one?
Oh, yeah, it was great. I liked the Justin Trudeau joke, so I think... Oh, but I'm not voting, so I don't know why I brought that up. it was just...
You can still say you liked a joke.
Yeah, it was good stuff, guys.
Okay, Brian Sex.
Wait, which one's Trudeau?
Trudeau is the Prime Minister of Canada.
I like that.
King of Canada.
I'm calling Trudeau. Redheaded kid. I love you as Trudeau. Both of you stunk. And I'll give it to the middle guy.
Me?
Yeah, you.
Cool,
you're
I
great.
Go one vote.
Pretty
are
objective.
Are comedians doing Xanax now? Is that what's happening? We stopped doing coke and we're doing bars now. Is that what's happening? Okay.
Shane Gillis, what do you think?
I have a spot shortly. Gotta hurry this up. If we're not voting, why are we doing this? Great first round. Round two.
Let's go to round two. It's going to be four jokes straight through. We'll start with Ryan. Round two starts now.
Bobby's pathetic, obviously, not a comic. He's the type of guy who his girlfriend would get double teamed by two guys in a bathroom at his birthday party, and he'd forgive her before they were done fucking. Oh, no, I do them again. Okay. Bobby's the grossest guy in his crew, and he hangs out with these guys. All right. Bobby looks like the gerbil that he would shove up his own ass.
One more.
Bobby looks like he listens to Kid Rock and Kid Rock wishes he would stop telling people that. Also, that's a little inside baseball because you need to know that Kid Rock loves stand-up comedy and hates gross guys that just do roasts.
Bobby Sheehan.
All right. Ryan, you have a real metrosexual white power vibe. Like you're in the KKK, but you're the head of their activities committee. Ryan writes for a website called The Hard Times. Hard times is also what he calls when he babysits or hugs a distant relative. You look like you buy beer for teenagers just so they'll invite you to their party.
One more.
You guys know the game Oogie Cookie? Yeah, it's a game where a bunch of men stand around a cookie and they take turns ejaculating onto it. Well, funny story. In high school, Ryan was the cookie.
Give it up for round two of this main event. See where we're at now. Brian Six, what do you think?
Dude, you fucking Ryan lit up in that, dude. You stink. Also, the hard times are gay as fuck, but that was great. Yeah, this guy over
Bobby.
Here. Short guy with the red hair.
Yes. You're killing with those mean comments all night, dude.
Jacob Williams.
Don't try and salvage it now, dude. You lost.
Okay. Yeah, I thought Bob did really well. This is like, when you use a lot taller, it's like watching a Jack the Giant Slayer parody called Jacking Off the Giant Gayer. All right. That's all I got. Thank you.
Shane Gillis.
Yeah, it was really good. Both of you guys are doing great. Yeah. Yeah, it's funny. It's good.
Kim Congdon.
Really good. Ryan, you look like Aaron Carter now. Bobby, I think you did really great again. My only critique for this round for you is when you described the, what was the name of the cookie thing?
Oogie Cookie.
Oogie Cookie, you didn't finish it. It's a bunch of men, they stand around and they jack off onto a cookie, and the last one to come has to eat the cookie. That's all.
It's a little fact-checking with Kim Condon. Olivia Grace.
Oh, it was good. I like that last joke. It was a bit of a slow burn for me, though. I was like, I think he just called you a cookie. And I'm like, no, he said you're covered in cum. You fucking idiot. Ryan, you look like you got sober and you sing songs on YouTube to 14-year-old girls about cutting yourself. And I'm leaning, again, leaning towards Bobby. But this could go either way, guys.
It's Fight Club. We are going to the third round right now. Are you excited for the third round of this fight? It'll be four jokes, tip for tat, starting with Bobby. Round three starts now.
Final round. Fight.
All right, Ryan, you look like a surfer that specializes in riding cocks. You're next. Pay attention.
Yeah, so you don't watch the roast battles. All right. Obviously, Bobby jerks off a whole lot. Bobby's like a cuck who can't get a girlfriend, so he just hires a black guy to fuck his hand.
That was just a factual statement. All right. How do you sound like a valley girl and look like the guy who told her not to press charges?
Shots fired! Shots fired!
Bobby looks like the government started growing an open micer in a lab and then ran out of funding halfway.
You look like you get White Claw enemas before being pegged by the guys from Good Charlotte.
Bobby's so boring and nondescriptive that in 5 years when they rescue the girls from their basement, they still won't be able to describe him to the police. Yeah, ma'am, we're going to need more info than just gross guy who does roasts.
I've been insulted a lot, but never nondescriptive. I'm small, I'm red, come on. All right, last joke. Ryan looks like one of the Queer Eye guys that they couldn't fix. Like they were trying to fix your wardrobe, but you just kept trying to suck their dicks.
Bobby's brutal stand-up comedy can be described as a boring one-man show from the perspective of the guy who raped Hannah Gatsby.
That was one hell of a main event. Fight, leave it over Bobby and Ryan for that main event. And we'll start with you guys. Do you think the winner of this fight is Bobby Sheehan? Or is the winner of this fight Ryan Long? Close, I think barely. Crowdville goes to Bobby Sheehan. We'll see what our judges say. Shane, we'll start with you. What do you think? Who do you think won?
I thought Bobby won. I thought Bobby won the thing. The more. Yeah, Bobby won. Yeah.
Shane votes for Bobby Sheehan.
What do you want me to do? Break down jokes? right? Is that the that's the job? Bobby, you won.
Kim Congdon.
That was a really good battle. I think that everyone knows that there was, sorry, I want to remember your names. It was really good. Bobby, you look like a pimple that you get on your ass. And Ryan, I've never been more sure that someone I've never met has herpes. I just know it, dude. Like, there's no hiding it. Your face says it all. I'm going to go. You guys both did great. You both had really great jokes. You should both be proud, but I'm going for Bobby.
It's another vote for Bobby Sheehan. Olivia Grace.
Yeah, you guys, that was great. Last round. Paid less attention to that one than the other ones, but I will say I'm still leaning towards Bobby. Bobby, you're great. Did you know that your whole name, Bobby Sheehan, sounds like a slur for Jews with red hair? Okay, good. I'm glad we cleared that up. I wanted you to go the rest of your life knowing that about yourself. But yeah, I'm going to give it to Bobby just because I also like that you do not get defensive at all. It's a really hard thing to do, and you're very much like lean with the punches kind of guy.
And he also looks just like you.
That's quite a compliment. You know, we're going to go home together now because you said that. See? Non-defensive.
Bobby getting raped later tonight, I'm pretty sure, but Brian
yeah,
sex.
I like no eyebrows. You are right. Also, where are your eyebrows? Have we not noticed this? Where's this kid's eyebrows? All right, you guys are fucking pussies. But this kid has no eyebrows. He was throwing roast jokes out. I like the kid in the purple shirt with the work boots on because I'm from Philly, and you look like you're struggling. Are you in the union?
No, I'm short, so
I don't give a shit. Boots too.
Jacob Williams.
All right, yeah, Kim said Ryan looks like he has herpes, although he doesn't actually get any spots. I think Bobby did really well. He probably took it. You both did well, but Bobby took it by a mile, or sorry, a kilometer. Bobby won that one.
Winner of this main event is Bobby Sheehan. And now it's time for the bishops to judge with our bishop. Give it up for Andrew Casertano.
Keep it going for Matt Maron, everybody. Yeah, how you guys doing? Let's connect. Keep it going for Philadelphia. Keep it going for the Liberty Bell. It has a big crack in it. Where'd you guys get that thing? France gave us a Statue of Liberty. Our pizza is the best. That's because we have the best water. We also cum the best. Our water tastes like cum. That's why we have the best dough. You're eating cum. Welcome to New York. Taste our cum. My last couple times up here, I haven't done that well. That's because Kim Congdon wasn't here. There was no reason to do well. What's up, Kim? Remember that time I won that Roastmasters tournament a few weeks ago? I won that money for you. Let's run away together. I tried to buy Kim a drink with the money I received, and she said no because she knows in her hot little heart I could never protect her. I have a milky body. Who wants to drink my milk? Shane Gillis was here tonight making fun of Alida and his brutal lisp. My name is Matt Mowen. My hosting is brutally honest. No fucking pity claps. I'm on your side, Shane. All right. Luke versus Dwayne. Big farm boy from Seattle versus a little hunky boy. We all want to kiss. What a fight. Remember when he was like, your dad is gay? Hell yeah. All right. Justin versus Rachel. You look like a retarded meatball. Come here, let me have sex with you. Oh my God. Oh my God, your pussy feels so weird. I'm gonna roast you later. So bad. I'm so lonely, man. I wish I had a meatball to have sex with. Hey, Andrew, show the audience how you have sex with your mother's meatballs. No, I can't do that. Show them, Andrew. Hey, Mom, did you cook meatballs for me tonight? Oh, put it on the table. Oh, yeah. Oh.
oh, Ma, why is Dad watching? I can't believe I'm fucking the meatballs. Oh, my God, this is going to be a bit in my act. It will be. Oh, I'm fucking your meatball. Oh, I'm having sex, Mommy. I'm finally having sex with your meatballs. Oh, oh, Mommy made me meatballs. I'm having sex with them. Who wants to come? All right. Guys, tonight I want to say be easy on yourselves and have fun. Thank you so much. That's it for me. Yeah.
The Bishop, Andrew Casertano.